Drinking buddies, drinking buddies, we're drinking buddies, we're drinking buddies that we like to drink. We're drinking buddies, we're drinking buddies, we're drinking buddies, we're drinking buddies that we like to drink. We're drinking buddies that we like to drink
responsibly.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another fun-filled, fact-packed episode of your favorite show and mine, Drinking Buddy. My name is Brian Roberts. You got it. My name is Brian Roberts. And as always, my good friend,
Harry Powers.
And once again, ladies and gentlemen, if you saw the last episode, you'll know who my guest here is to my right. His name is Terry, and he's getting married this weekend. And so the double episode of Drinking Buddies is all about Bachelor Party number 2. So we've already had the barrel-aged Black Manhattan. What could possibly top that experience? Harry, take it away.
We are going to make one of our favorite drinks.
I love this cocktail.
The Aviation.
Oh.
And we have two gins from which to make the Aviation.
Which one are we going to choose?
We are going to choose the Aria Portland Dry Gin.
Oh, man.
90 proof.
Oh, yeah.
But I have also made this drink with Aviation Gin, the Aviation Cocktail with Aviation Gin. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a great gin.
It is.
But tonight, because it's a special evening, I'm going to use my top shelf Aria.
So if you are not from Portland, you probably cannot get Aria Gin. I am lucky enough to go to Portland on a regular basis, and every time I go up there, I will bring back a bottle of Aria for him, because it is fantastic gin. And if the people of Aria are paying attention, please pay us a lot of money, because this is a great, great gin. But Aviation is pretty great too. It's just easier to get a hold of, so please try it with aviation gin, because it's delicious. But the Aria, in my opinion, so much better. And we're going to do it with Aria tonight. So let's
do it. We're going to do it with Aria tonight.
Tell us how you make it.
How we make it. For one drink, 2 ounces of gin. Oof. And again tonight, we're going to use Aviation. Aria. We're going to use Aria. 1/2 ounce of maraschino liqueur, per drink.
Which brand of maraschino are you using?
Luxardo.
Luxardo, okay.
And 1/4 ounce of creme de violette.
Oh my gosh, the nectar of the gods. So good.
And 3/4 ounce of fresh squeezed lemon juice. And I did that earlier today.
Thank you, Harry, for saving us all the time that it would take to squeeze all the lemons.
So we got this.
Mm-hmm. No, that was not squeezed, it was squeezed.
Squeezed. Is that the past tense of squeeze?
It's Navy.
They don't know how to speak, but they can drive a boat.
That is the Harry way of
the Harry way.
That's a show.
We're gonna do an entire episode on Harryism. So it's so fun.
So when you build a drink, the suggestion is that you use the first thing you put in the mixing glass is the least expensive.
Now why would you do the cheapest ingredient first, Harry?
If you make a mistake, you don't waste a lot of money.
Exactly. Don't put in your high-value spirit first, because if you jack it up or screw it up or something's wrong, you don't want to pour that out.
So,
but you can pour out lemon juice.
So for 3 drinks, 2.25 ounces of freshly squeezed lemon juice.
2.25 ounces.
Okay. Yeah, 0.75 ounce per drink.
Well, there are no mathematicians out there. That's 3/4 ounce to the rest of you.
Okay, we are going to do 1.5 ounces.
There we go.
Of Luxardo maraschino liqueur.
Notice he changes the bottle. Apparently, Luxardo is not paying us, so we don't even show their logo on the screen. Harry's really serious about this. Luxardo.
You want to know what happened?
Tell me what happened, Harry. Broke the bottle.
So I'm using a Campari bottle because the cap on the one bottle of maraschino liqueur that I bought in Richmond, Virginia, broke, and we had to filter it through. So we're
nice.
Good.
Okay, good. As long as we saved it.
So
throwing it out.
Maraschino liqueur, is that the essence of maraschino cherry?
Basically, yes. Yeah. So it comes from the Marasca cherry. You would think it would be red,
Yeah.
But it's not. It is a liqueur made from the sweetness of the cherry. So it is.
Interesting.
Yeah, right?
So we're going to do 3/4 of an ounce of this.
Oh, so this is made from violet flowers. So that whole thing is thousands of violet flowers. And it is so good. So good. If you've ever taken a hibiscus.
Who has ever thought about drinking violet flowers?
Somebody, you know what? Back in 1412, when all these monks were out in the fields and they had violets, they were like, let's make some alcohol. Who cares?
Cream de viola. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Lemon. We got the lemon juice. We got the violette. Did we do gin already?
We did not do the gin.
That's the important part.
But ladies and gentlemen, this right here that I have in my hand is the magic.
It is the magic.
You
That's
saw
the Aria lid, just so you took the magician. You got the wrong lid.
I done.
There you go. We've been drinking. It's okay.
That's that Navy.
The Navy technique. That's the Navy. Whatever. Any lid is fine. Any lid in a storm. Is that what they say?
Any soldier or Marine, they know what lid goes to what bottle.
Poor Harry takes so much grief from us, but we love you, Harry. You're my boy.
Hey, if it wasn't for Harry, I would have never met my wife.
That seems like a story.
That's a story.
Should be told. Like you said, I was in high school in ROTC and in DeMolay, he was one of the advisors in DeMolay, and he knew that I was into the military and was going to join.
Yeah,
and he asked me to join a Aviation Explorers program based on Air Force at Chino Airport.
Yeah.
And through that organization, I met my wife's two brothers.
Oh, wow.
And
two brothers? That's usually the wrong way to go.
They were members, and then that was... what year was that, Harry? That was
2002.
Yeah, about 2002.
Nice.
And I stayed friends with her two brothers, and I knew her parents.
You would have to be their friends.
Yeah. And
start dating their sister.
When we went on our first date, I asked her brothers if it was okay.
Nice.
And they said, yes, that's fine. We went on our first date. And it just...
The rest is history.
Yeah.
And then this weekend will be the culmination of this story as you become wedded.
So I have him to thank for me meeting my wife.
Harry. Hey. You know what? Exactly. He should be paying for these cocktails then.
Oh, I don't know what I'll ask.
So what... he called me the other day and he asked me if I would...
Shake it up.
If I would do him a favor.
Oh, what you got here? This is party foul. You cannot.
Not making it.
You cannot.
That's alcohol.
That's sealant. Is it just that there's too much in there?
Yeah,
probably there's too much in there.
Not making a good seal.
Get the regular lid.
You want me to give it a try?
Normal lid.
I don't.
It's just there's way too much volume in there. I think. Drum roll, Harry.
There it is.
That's experience. That's cocktail experience.
All right. So he called me the other day and asked me if I would do a toast at his wedding.
Nice.
And I was very taken by that.
Of course.
And thank you, Terry. And so I asked him. I didn't know that Samantha was in the car with him.
Oh.
And I said, how did you sneak up on her and get her to say yes? And he said, 15 years of
effort. Now that move can be construed a lot of ways, Harry. Don't even start down that road, Harry.
15 years
of that will get anyone.
I was able to wear her down.
Exactly.
That's exactly what he said. I was able to wear her down. After 50 years, I love it.
There we go.
So, ladies and gentlemen,
the Aviation.
This is a great cocktail. I encourage you to try this. Hopefully, your favorite cocktail lounge will know how to make this. There are people who don't have the secret ingredients, which is really the creme de violette.
So if you go to a cocktail bar and they are making it with creme de Yvette, Forget it. Yvette that is yellow, and it is okay. It tastes similar, but the real way of making it is because the cocktail becomes sky blue, the aviation. You have to make it with Violette. So
sky blue, aviation.
You know, I was in a bar in at an airport. I'm trying to remember what it was. It was Dallas, Dallas Fort Worth. I think it was in Dallas Fort Worth. It was 10 a.m. in the morning. And I go to, we're waiting for a flight, and my wife and my kids are with me, and we go to this thing, and these guys are shaking cocktails at 10 in the morning at DFW, I think it was DFW, and I sit down at this place, and they had aviation on the menu. I've got to try, because I know what aviations are supposed to taste like, so I order the aviation.
Such an airport, I would think every airport would have aviation on
there. They should, right? They should, absolutely. And it was spectacular. So Steve, if you do not remember me, and you're not even watching, but Steve, you made a fantastic cocktail that day. Thank you very much.
How long ago was this?
This had to be 3 years ago.
And you remember the bartender's name?
I remember, because I went up to him.
That tells you how good the drink was.
I went up to him and I shook his hand. I was like, you know what? Not many people know how to make a proper aviation egg. Who knew it would be at the DFW airport?
At 10:30 in the morning.
At 10 o'clock in the morning. So I asked Therese for permission if I could get a cocktail at 10.
Cheers. Cheers, Ellen.
Cheers to you.
Hey, and remember, it's always 5 o'clock somewhere.
It's always 5 o'clock somewhere, man. So, you know, happy wedded bliss to you, sir.
Thank you.
You know, may your wedding day be the worst day of your marriage.
Wow.
Is that an Irish thing?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That
the Irish. Like yes, exactly. May your wedding day be the worst.
What do you think of that, Terry?
I love it.
That's really good.
One of my greatest.
There's a few other cocktails that we like.
Really sweet.
French.
Yeah, there's some sweetness to it, but that gin kind of takes the Violette is very sweet. It's like grape syrup
compared to straight whiskey.
Well, of course. Absolutely. Well, yes. I mean, if you're going there. Sure. Any sweetness at all would be sweet.
You guys are opening my eyes.
Right? I would hope so. There's
different stuff.
A world of fantastic cocktails. As a matter of fact, and this is another thing, I don't think we've ever, I was going to reach for my phone, but we're filming with it. There's a great app on the iPhone called, Highball.
Highball.
Wait.
And you can keep.
Wait, do you have an iPhone?
I do.
We cannot be friends.
Oh, I'm sorry, Terry. I'm sorry. I'm a deep cat guy, so you don't get the hell out. But there's a great app called Highball where you can trade and record great cocktail recipes.
Oh, I wonder if they have one in some of that.
I'm sure they do. I'm sure they have one for Android. Because I know they don't have, last I checked, they didn't have it for Android. But the guys at Highball need to get their act together because Android users.
Some
as
people need to
Android
users share.
As low as they happen to be on the scale of humanity, they need good cocktails too. Anyway, that is the aviation again from Drinking Buddies. So remember, we here at Drinking Buddies are always drinking responsibly, and you should too. Please make this cocktail. Tell us what you think in the liner notes down at the bottom. And you know, if you're a hater, screw you. Anyway,
I can drink this.
I've never said that before. At the second cocktail of that, you know what? It's okay. I'll edit out. I might know how to edit it out. Anyway,
that's the marine side.
That's the marine side sneaking through. So remember, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching, and tune in next time for your favorite show and mine,
Drinking Buddies. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great evening.
You too.
Do drive carefully.
Indeed.
Cheers.
Or Keisha.